we just heard a big noise. All the, you know, the ceiling and the wall fell on us. I felt, you know, the fire on my body, and I couldn't see anything now. I lost my arms, and my body is burned, and also my family, they're dead.
The next thing I know, the floor above me collapsed. The cables dropped from the ceiling. The sprinkler system came on. It looked like somebody took a giant bag of cement, threw it in the air. Piece of the plane wing or whatever part broke out and is stuck in a doorway 20 feet from where I am. And I'm literally covered with debris. I'm holding on to mangled furniture, and I'm scared to get sucked out because of the air pressure.
And at that point, I started screaming, "Help me, help me, help me, stop them." And passengers came from over the middle aisles, from forward, from back. Passengers were on top of me, behind me. I instructed the passengers to hold him down.
You know, he told me that he didn't think he was gonna make it out of the plane, and I said, "Don't be silly. Of course you're gonna make it, be brave. Put a picture of me and Emmy, and Emmy is who our daughter, who was 11 weeks old, in your head, and be brave, and we're gonna get through this." You know, he said they were gonna take a vote. Did I think it was a good idea for him to attack the hijackers?
Everybody was there that morning. And the reason I was not there is I was taking my son, Kyle, to his first day of kindergarten.
He said, "It's positive. You've had an anthrax attack."
I was able to lift the wall up enough to scurry under.
We were focused especially on this problem of weapons of mass destruction.
I truly recognize that the administration's rhetoric was not matching up with the intelligence.
I'm gonna go to Crawford, and I'm gonna go to wherever George Bush is living, and I'm gonna ask him for a meeting.
When you're the leader of an organization, you've gotta be resolute, compassionate, and you gotta know what you need to do. And I knew what we needed to do. I knew we needed to use all resources of our government to defend the American people.
It is as long as the Cold War. And we're now marking the 10th anniversary of those attacks, and I think we've made great progress in this struggle.
America ultimately prevails. This is a very short period where we are being tested as a community. I think that the extremist days are numbered.